When we buy our food at the grocery store, we look at the price tag, but we don't usually think about the cost that growing food has on the environment. What if we could grow food that had less of an environmental impact while at the same time saving farmers money? Crops need nutrients to grow and be productive. That's why we apply fertilizer. They need more nitrogen than any other nutrient. Nitrogen readily moves through the soil. That makes it accessible to growing crops, but it can also leach downward into the groundwater and out into bodies of water. In estuaries, such as the Chesapeake Bay, nitrogen inputs can cause serious problems, such as massive die-offs of shellfish or a buildup of toxic algae that can be harmful to human health. Corn and soybean agriculture tend to leak nitrogen. First, they're only growing from May through August. That leaves most of the year where there's no crop taking up nitrogen. Second, corn only uses about half of the nitrogen fertilizer that's applied to it. So the first question I asked is how much nitrogen is left at the end of the corn and soybean growing season? To find out, I took deep soil cores on 25 farms across Maryland and Pennsylvania. I found huge pools of nitrogen. The amount of nitrogen I found was 2 times the amount that a farmer would typically apply to a corn crop. If farmers could capture and recycle this pool of nitrogen that's already in their soil, they could save big on fertilizer costs and at the same time prevent this nitrogen from polluting bodies of water. So I began investigating how to use deep-rooted plants planted in the fall to capture and recycle this pool of nitrogen. First, I buried a nitrogen isotope tracer, basically a way to track how nitrogen moves from the soil to the plants. Next, I planted radish and rye. If I planted the radish and rye by early September, they quickly grew deep roots and captured nitrogen from 6 feet deep by December. But early planting was key. If I planted them in October, they would only capture nitrogen from 2 feet deep. Next, I took this practice to the farms. Over 20 farmers volunteered to plant trials of radish and rye. We had similar results, where if the radish and rye was planted by early September, they would capture deep soil nitrogen. Furthermore, the radish would die over the winter and decompose, releasing its nitrogen on the soil surface. Now the nitrogen's at the right place and the right time to be used by the following corn crop. This is a straightforward practice, essentially letting plants do what they're good at. Plants scavenge leftover nitrogen, which keeps it out of bodies of water. Next, the plants die and release this nitrogen on the soil surface, which provides a free form of fertilizer for the following crop. We end up with a win-win situation for crop production and for water quality. Thank you.